and welcome to another BookTube video from me, Lauren, from Lauren and the Books. I feel like I've stepped straight out of a Katy Perry video because I've got parrots and palm leaves on my dress, and it is the coolest dress ever. It's massive and it's just so cool and lovely. But today I'm going to be talking about the books that I have DNF'd so far this year. So books that I've put down this year, either because, well, mainly because I haven't been enjoying them. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start this video with a little disclaimer. Just to say, just because I didn't enjoy these books doesn't mean to say that somebody else won't enjoy these books, or one of you yourselves may well have enjoyed these books. I made a video earlier this... Hello, Minnie. Poof, tail. She's gone. I made a video earlier this year, a Lit Chat video, about books that I've DNF'd, just in general. And I think the comments in the video prove that so many people have different thoughts on not finishing a book, or books that you consider to hate may not be books that other people consider to hate. So, I mean, let's like chat in the comments and let's have a chat and everything. But just to say, just because I'm saying I don't like these books doesn't mean that someone else hasn't or will not like these books. But anyway, let's get going. So I've made notes and everything on this, guys. I got this book, this 2018 diary. Now, I'm aware we're in June now, so we're like halfway through. This was £3 in Kiki K, and it's got lovely big bits for writing. So I'm going to do all my video prep in here. So good for me. And also I get to write in fun coloured pens. So anyway, we're going on. I need to get on with the book. So I haven't done them in any particular order. They basically just come to, like, books that I haven't read. I've made a note of all the books that I haven't finished, and it's 7 for this year so far. And these are them. So the first one is A Street Cat Named Bob by James Bowen. This is a book that I read for my book club at work. It was put in, so at work we, a lot of people add books as we go through the year, and then as we pull them out, so it might be like someone else's choice, it might be a prize winner, it might be something I've put in. This was the choice of another person. Now, David has read this book and he has loved this book, but for me, the writing just wasn't for me. So it's about James Bowen. It's a memoir about himself and him being a big issue seller on the streets of London. He's a homeless chap, and he gets a cat, a street cat, who he calls Bob. And I'm sure like everyone has read the book or seen a film or something. The writing wasn't for me. Now, James Bowen isn't a writer. That's not his like forte. He's just written a book about his experiences, and that for me really showed. And I read a book not mainly like because of plot or things like that. I read it for the characters and for the description and things like that, and this book just wasn't written for people who like characters and description. That being said, David loved it. He gave it 5 stars. He keeps talking about it and saying how wonderful it was. A few people in the book club really loved it as well. And yeah, it was just parts of it, like, for instance, like, it would say something like, oh, I thought he'd hurt his paw, and he had, so I took him to the vets. It's just like that sort of writing, which, like, for some people, like, who like plot and things like that, would definitely run along quite well with them. But for me, I couldn't finish it. And after I got to sort of like 60% way of the way through, like, it was over halfway, and book club happened, and I was like, I'm just not going to finish it. What I will say, though, is for the people that I had with me in book club, a lot of them felt very educated on this, mainly to do with the big issue, she says, as she finds, I've got a big issue. That wasn't even planned. That's one I bought earlier last week, I think I got that one. A lot of people didn't realise the business nature behind the big issue, and how the homeless people have to buy their copies to sell on and things like that, and they have to go through sort of rigorous checks and things like that. And a lot of people said that since reading the book that they have bought the big issue. So I feel like in that way, then yeah, great, but for me, it just wasn't for me. It was too simply written, and yeah, I just didn't finish it. The next one is Clean by Juno Dawson. I did this as a buddy read with Simon from Savage Reads and Jean from Jean's Bookish Thoughts. I don't know why I said they're full channels. I don't normally do things like that. This to me was just bloody daft. It's not the first bit of fiction by Juno Dawson that I've read. I've also read Hollow Pike, which I really enjoyed. It's quite based on the craft. But Clean is about a sort of socialite girl in her late teens, going to rehab to come get over a drug addiction she's got, which you would think would be a very serious topic, but it is just daft. This book is just like, it reads like a really crap episode of Made in Chelsea. It was just trashy, which can be good, but for me, this just was not trashy, like, sometimes I feel like trashy books are fun, and let me tell you, I've read a Jackie Collins in my time back in the day, and I used to enjoy a bit of trashy Jackie Collins fun, but this was just, I just didn't like this. It was just so, it was just like, serious white privilege going on, like, the whole way through, and I know that was sort of like part of the story, is that this girl was so privileged and she was able to get herself into this rehab clinic, but it just didn't go with me. Also, I feel like it had a really, really casual use of the C word for a book that is, like, marketed towards 14-year-olds. Like, I wouldn't be comfortable as a 14... Would I have read it as a 14-year-old? I probably would have done. But I don't know. Just for me, it just, like, smatters. It just felt a bit cheap and nasty, and I just couldn't finish it. That's not to say, like, The Gender Games, which is a non-fiction book by Juno Dawson, is one of my favourite books, like, non-fiction books ever. It was one of my favourite books of last year. Really, really loved it. But this was just not for me, and I could not finish it. I didn't get very far in it at all. I was just like, nope, this is not going to work for me. The next one is The Button Box, which is a non-fiction book about women's fashion throughout the ages. This was boring. I read, like, the first chapter. I really, really hoped it, like, on the front, like, the synopsis sounded like something I'd be so into, but I just found it really dull. And it wasn't even like that particular time of the age that we were working through in terms of fashion was dull for me. I just found the writing quite dull. I had really high hopes and it was going to be great. I'd picked it up for February, which was a month where I read all books by female authors and about female history and things like that, and yeah, it just didn't work for me. Here I've put, I might go back to it, but when I think about it, I really don't think I will, so that's a shame really, because I really had high hopes for that one and it just was no good. The next one is Sour Heart, which is a short story collection by Jenny Zhang. It's a short story collection about Chinese immigrants coming, Chinese and Taiwan, immigrants from China and Taiwan coming over to the USA and trying to make a living for themselves. And I read the first and second story. The first story I quite enjoyed, but the second story was just, it was horrifying. It was about, it basically had the rape of a young boy in it and a young girl, and it was just, it was like, I just felt like it sexualized children a bit. I was just reading it like, oh, the whole way through. And I commented, I was talking about it in an At The Moment video, like, this is what I'm reading at the moment, I don't know if I'm going to get on with it. Like, I've just, the first story I enjoyed, but the second story I did not enjoy. And they're all interlinking, so, like, one of the characters in the first story appeared in the second story. So they're all sort of interlinking. But and when I said, like, I had not enjoyed the second story, a few people commented below and said, I think you'll probably find that you won't enjoy the rest of the collection then, because they felt like the first story was definitely one that eased you into what went on to be quite a horrific set of stories. Like, my face is telling it all, really. I felt so uncomfortable reading it, and I just didn't like it at all. It was really graphic and I was really unprepared for it, and I couldn't do it anymore, so I put it down. The end of that. The next one was Truly Madly Guilty by Leanne Moriarty. That is another That is another book club book. Leanne Moriarty, I've read her before. I've read The Husband's Secret and quite enjoyed it. I am a big fan of the series Big Little Lies. But this was just massive and nothing really happened. So it tells the story, as many Leanne Moriarty books do, of sort of a number of couples and their children, and something's happened or something's going to happen. You're building up to it, or you're dealing with the aftermath of it. In this case, you were sort of flitting in between the build up to a barbecue that was going to happen and then what was happening after the barbecue. I cannot give a shit what happened after the barbecue, because the build up to it was just so long and so drawn out that I just wanted it to be over. It was, I got sort of like halfway through, I still hadn't found out what was going to happen. I didn't care what was going to happen. We talked about it at book club. A lot of people who had read the whole book said that they were really disappointed with this event that had happened, that had really been built up to. And yeah, it just fell flat for me. I feel like she writes really good characters, and as I said, I've enjoyed The Husband's Secret and Big Little Lies, but this for me was just so long, and it does look significantly longer than the rest of our books. So I don't know if maybe it was just that, like, maybe that's her writing for me works in a sort of punchy, let's bash it all out within about 300 pages deal, rather than like almost 500 pages of not fun writing. Almost last one is The Possessions by Sarah Flannery Murphy. I think this is, I've given basically all of these books away, so I would have inserted photos into them because I don't own them anymore. This, on the cover of it, like on the front of it, sounded like it was going to be really great. I bought it in any amount of books in London on a BookTube meetup, and it's a book about a dystopian world where after the death of a loved one, you are able to go to a place called the Elysian Society, and they have workers there who are called bodies who take pills to become the person you love, so you're able to have an interaction with them. It is very similar to a Black Mirror episode, I believe. And I don't know what came first, but it was just dull. Like, you were just hearing about one of the bodies that worked in the Elysian Society, and one of her clients, and it was just so like back and forth with like building up to not much, and I got about 40% through, and I was just like, no, I can't be bothered anymore. When I took a lot of these books, I take to work and give them to my book club friends. And one of the women who there, when I said about what it was about, she was like, that sounds brilliant, I'm definitely going to read it. So I would be interested. I'd be interested, actually, for those who have finished that book, The Possessions, by Sarah Flannery Murphy, if it is any good, because I just didn't have the patience for it. I just gave up on it. And then the last one is one that I've put down recently. Now, I've included it in the DNF video, and I have spoken about this book already. It is I'll Be Gone in the Dark, which is a non-fiction true crime book about the Golden State Killer. Now, I've read 40 pages of this, and it terrified me. So it absolutely terrified me. And I've sort of said to myself, I've lent it to someone at work who loves true crime and who loves thrillers and things like that, and I think she'll really enjoy it. And I've said to her, I will have it back after her. So I'm not saying no to that forever, but at the moment, and like, just after I've read 40 pages, I was just like, oh no, I don't want to read anymore. I was so frightened. So I've lent it to a braver friend at work. I'm going to see how she gets on with it, and I may well go back to it. But at the moment, it is on a sort of like not going to be picked up anytime soon page. So those are the 7 books that I have DNF'd so far this year. Let me know if you have enjoyed this, because I don't include books that I don't finish in my wrap-ups, because I don't have time to talk about the books that I don't read, because I'm often talking about 12 to 15 other books, and it would just get too much, wouldn't it, guys? Just get too much. So 7 books. I am getting better at picking what books I know I'm going to like, and as you'll notice, the books here that I haven't finished are mainly, well, 2 of them are book club books, so they're often books that I wouldn't normally pick for myself. So I am getting better at picking up books that I would always finish. So I feel like there's not that many DNFs these days, and I'm also much better at allowing myself to DNF. I did a whole video on DNFing with Eleanor, from Eleanor Reads Book, and so I'll link that down below. So let me know if you've enjoyed this. Let me know if you'd like me to do one for the last half of the year. Guys, we're halfway through the year. You know what it means. It's coming on the slow down to Christmas. Exciting. But I'm off out for dinner now. I'm off out for dinner with my mum and her sisters, so imagine that. And I've got to nip to my mum and dad's house, upload this, bish bash bosh. See you all on Sunday for another BookTube video. Goodbye.